day three, we decided to drive to the Vegas sign. We wanted to see the 58 individual crosses that had been erected there for the victims of the Vegas shootings. I decided not to release this video for loads of reasons, but mainly because I just didn't know what to say. We'd heard lots in the news, and I was fascinated by the guy that travelled like 2,000 miles from Chicago just to erect these memorials. We just had to go there and pay our respects. I mean, we adore Vegas. Shit, we got married in Vegas, and some fuckface aimlessly killing people in the city we love really upset us both, more than we could imagine. With these memorials, families and friends were able to go somewhere to pay tribute to their loved ones and share the good times, but also they were able to mourn. We saw letters from mums and dads and brothers and sisters, and even children of the victims. There were flowers and flags and teddy bears, as far as the eye could see. All of this was overlooked by the Vegas sign, you know, the bright lights of the Strip, and by Mandalay Bay Hotel with its very own Vegas strong banner high above the Strip. With all the 58 crosses lined up in a row, it makes you realise the extent of this attack. 58 sons and daughters. And there are still people in front of the Vegas sign smiling and jumping in front of it. All smiles. And it just seemed callous. And I know life goes on, but it just seemed wrong to us. A short time later, we wandered over to the Mandalay Bay Hotel. And it was as much the same there, really. There were flowers and more letters, candles, still with a huge sense of unity, with flags from all over the world, including Scotland. I realise this isn't our usual fun, happy video. All I can say is thank you for watching, but I had to say something. And Vegas, we'll see you soon.